Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're diving into how you can use the gallery function inside of Notion to create recipes, to organize your own journal, and even start projects too. So we're going to dive into that in today's video. So guys, just before we dive into this video, you can check out the new PDF. It has over 1,250, not that I'm being specific, downloads already. There's no sign up, it's just a beginner's guide to Notion that will take you through some useful insights. And also a little plug as well, do join the newsletter, the monthly newsletter from Keep Productive, which gives you outlines to all of the best tools, resources, and content. So please do check that out below. So guys, yes, we are diving into the new gallery function. You may be seeing it here in front of you. That's because I'm starting now to use it as my almost pinned notes experience. And I'm gonna explain why at the end of this video. So if you wanna stay tuned for that, just wait till this end of the video. So we're gonna actually show you how the gallery function works today. So I'm really just gonna simply create a page, get started by creating a recipe guide, and then I'm going to dive into how to create a journal as well as also use it for projects too. So let's dive in. So the really simple way to create a brand new gallery in line is by pressing the slash button and typing in gallery. So you can create a full page gallery if you wanted to, if you wanted a lovely full bleed one. But in this case, I'm just gonna create a very simple gallery in line. So here we are, I'm gonna say recipes. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm gonna create a couple of recipes for a couple of things that I find on Google. So I'm gonna quickly populate it. Okay, so what I've done is I've saved three pictures of all of these things here. So let's start with the carrot cake. And the first thing that you can do is actually grab hold of it inside of your Finder and actually drag it on. Now, as you can see, it's created one here. So I actually didn't need to create this one. And as you can see right here, it's actually created an automatic thumbnail for it. So I can actually get rid of this one and I can go into this one and rename this one carrot cake. Now this is absolutely killing me because I am a big fan of carrot cakes. I have one pretty much every Thursday. So let's add the other images for the other two. So just to be clear, that's one thing it doesn't do. If you drag in images, it tends to make the actual image thing for it. But if you want to actually add the image below it, all you have to do is drag it as part of the page content. And as you can see, it appears here. But in this case, I'm actually just gonna get rid of this one and do the same for this easy pancakes over here. So if you want everything inside of the contents to be showing, so for example, these images, all you have to do is go to properties and make sure the page content is showing. If you don't have it showing, you see a very plain experience, and that's not so great if you're using it, for example, for a recipe, because you want to see the recipe. Now, if I click into carrot cake, it's really simple. What I'm going to start doing is start adding a few properties based on what I want to have with the ingredients. Okay, so here we go. I've pre-created a few things. I actually copied them from Google because I probably would butcher a carrot cake if I actually made it. Now I've added a simple type, and as you can imagine, once you edit these, all of the others are edited inside of the gallery, so I can start adding these in a moment. Now as you can imagine, I can click here, and as you can see, it's the actual time I created it. In this extent, I'm actually gonna delete this one because there's no need to have this. But I put type here, and that's a simple dessert. I basically pasted the ingredients for the feature here, although I could have put them at the bottom with the methods. I've also added a number here for time taken and how many people it will serve when I actually bake it. And as you can see here, down below the image is a nice method of how to create that so that I don't go wrong. Now the final icing on the cake, and that really was an awful pun, is the icon. So I'm just gonna put a carrot and it should appear here. So as you can see, a lovely carrot appears and you've got the pierre de la resistance and everything there. Now I can do this really easily now for this. I'm gonna actually put this one as a dessert. I could add the ingredients, the time taken, and how many people it serves, as well as the method below. And if you shared this with other people, you can add comments and relevant icons there. Now, if I wanted to just find the pancake icon, which I don't know exists, yes, it does exist, then I could easily do that there. And that's a really easy way to create a recipe gallery inside of Notion. So next up is a journal. So let's delete this one, or actually I don't want to delete it because I've done such a good job at creating it. I'm going to actually create a journal experience here. So as you can see, I've created a new one inline, I've cleared it, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to add a new entry. So this could be new, or let's say a day at the Chester Zoo, which we went to recently. So I'm just going to add a few properties, and then I'm going to populate it just to demonstrate what you can do if it was a journal. Okay, so here we are. I've just created a brand new journal entry, and this can be really easy to do and really easy to create inside the gallery. And what I quite like about it is it's very visual and easy to do. Now, before I show you what this looks like inside as a demonstration, I'm going to go up here to properties. And as I mentioned before, you can really thin this down if you wanted to, but in this case, I'm actually going to keep that content. So for example, if you didn't want any images, you didn't have to have that. But what I'm going to demonstrate is that you can have all of these different properties on. So for example, maybe I wanted to see the date, I wanted to see the location, maybe I want to see the mood I was in, but not in this case, how many steps I walked, because I know a lot of people like that, or the type of activity. So I'm going to keep the type of activity on, and as you can see here, there's quite a nice outline. So I visited September 1st, 21st, Chester Zoo it was, and the day out there. So if I click in, you can see here I've added the date for when the actual date it was on, the type of day out it was, so you could have that. I know some people like to track their mood with stuff like that. And also location, I don't know, there's no location property here, so I can't specifically assign it to something. And how many steps walked, because I know people like to connect there. And down below here, I could maybe start entering what it would the experience was like, and that's quite an easy way to create a journal. Now to round things off, I'm going to create some projects. So let's dive into that as the final piece of the puzzle. Okie dokie, so let's say I'm planning an event conference. I'm going to create a brand new gallery entry for that and start to populate the properties area. So as you can see here, I've created the event conference, a basic card inside of this gallery. So you can see here that I added a created. I'm actually going to create dates of event, actually change the title of it, but I've put them between two dates, an end date, as well as setting a reminder for 2 days before. So that's a quite a neat way to be able to see stuff. And if I wanted to at any given point, I could change that into a calendar. So for example, if I wanted to go, okay, I actually want to see this as a calendar view, so I get an idea of when the events conference is coming up, I can easily do so. So that's an added bonus of adding things that were spread out. If I click here again, I can see the event type, I can see the people that are involved. I can also add event details, and in this case, I'm going to actually add a file. So there we are, I've added a basic, the actual file for this one. I've also got a checkbox as well, so that's a simple checkbox property type here that I can tick and cross, as well as notes below. Now I've also created inside of the page content a table view so that I can see the guest list and some of the people that are invited. Now if I delete this one because I accidentally added that one in, I also added some email addresses. In this case, I just need to change that one to email and also the phone numbers of those people. So that's a really easy way to be able to add a table below. And as you can see here, it's in lovely gallery view. So you could have a few projects that outstand here. If I went over to properties, I could quite easily see the date of the event or the event type, for example, or even get the actual event file available. So for example, if I went to event details, I can actually view it like a card preview there. And I can also see the actual checklist. So if I wanted the two checklist items just to appear here, they wouldn't be actually clickable. But you could then go in and actually click them. So it's almost a preview there, not anything there. And also you could get the people that were invited to. But in this case, I'm just going to keep things super duper simple. You could also, if you wanted to, for example, if you added a cover and it also brought up that cover, you could see that the cover gets imported too. That's something I didn't note just before, but that's possible if you just go to page cover. If you wanted page contents, you could see that there. Now, it's a really simple way to create some recipes, journals, and projects inside of Gallery View. I'm going to go back to home because I want to demonstrate what I've done with my own layout. So I used to have like pinned area here. I'll probably demonstrate this in the full Notion setup video, but I actually used to have a pinned area here, but I've actually created a gallery here. And the reason why I've done that is because I wanted my inbox and my daily log to be in this sort of view. So the real benefit of this is when I click in, I get this almost like tab view of it, so I get this really lovely outline where I can start adding articles. And it actually has been a lot better in terms of being able to add stuff, because it's not like a preview window. I can actually open it up as a full page if I wanted to, like I used to would have, but in this case I've actually just got its own welcome tab too, so I could click in and view that as a page if I wanted to, but in this case it's just like a preview. And the way you get the preview is go to properties and actually just have page contents on card preview. If I wanted to, I could add obviously the tags and stuff like that, but don't have any that's related. Now, I've also done this for my daily log so that I can quickly access a little bit of a journal that I'm experimenting with, a health area that I'm also experimenting with and still going with, and also my workout routine and whether I've done it or not, as well as the personal budget area, which I've only recently started. So galleries is an experimental function. One thing I notice is you can just saw it there. It takes a little bit of a second or two to load, so do take note of that. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this one. Hopefully you found it valuable. I will be doing more features very soon, so please do stay tuned. If you're a brand new subscriber, please do like this video. If you are not a subscriber, it'd be great to have you. If you're from the Facebook group, thank you very much for your inspirations on the recipe side of stuff. You've done a fantastic job at putting together your own setup, so this is what inspired this video. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very, very soon. Cheers.